إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله لا نبي بعده اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد فيا عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله تعالى وطاعته لعلكم تفلحون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون صدق الله العظيم الحمد لله Alhamdulillah. All praises and thanks to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala for all the blessings that we have, including the blessing that we have today. Today is Friday, which is the best day of the week in Islam. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, whoever come to the Friday prayer, listen to the khutbah attentively, then Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will forgive his sins until the next Friday. And also, this month is the month of Ramadan, which is the best month in Islam. So we are in the two best conditions today. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, "Man soma Ramadan imanan wahtisaban, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." Whoever fasts in the month of Ramadan with iman, with the firm belief and hope, then Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will forgive his previous sins. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam also mentioned, "Man qama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." Whoever pray at night in Ramadan, pray the Taraweeh prayer with iman, with firm belief and hope, then Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will forgive his previous sin. So let Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala make us from the one that he will forgive. But Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam also gave a reminder, a warning. He said, "Rubba sa'imin laysa lahu min siyamihi illa ju'. He said that there are some people that fasting in Ramadan, but they don't get anything except hunger. Wa rubba qa'imin laysa lahu min qiyamihi illa shahr. And there are some people that come to the Laylatul, praying at night, Tarawih prayer, but they don't get anything except feeling tiredness, sleeplessness. So this is the warning. If we only fast just for restraining from eating and drinking, then we don't really know what is actually fasting for. Our understanding is maybe the same like non-Muslim, but understand fasting is you're not eating during the day, you're not drinking during the day, it's going to be very difficult, very hard. It is not only that. Remember what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Baqarah, ayat number 183. A'udhu billahi minasyaitanir rajim. Ya ayyuhalladzina amanu kutiba alaikumusiyam kama kutiba ala alladzina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. Oh, who you believe, fasting in Ramadan is prescribed for you, like fasting also prescribed for people before you. La'allakum tattaqun. So you will attain taqwa. You will increase your iman. You will increase to obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the goal of fasting. It's not only hungry and thirsty. Now, we have to know the adabs, the manner of fasting in order to attain this taqwa. There are several things that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned and make a sunnah for us. What is the first thing? It is very important. The first thing is eat sahur. Don't be lazy to wake up before fajr time and eat sahur, because it is a sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in order to attain that taqwa. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Faslu ma siyamina wa siyami ahlil kitab aqlatus sahur." The difference between the fasting of us, the believer, and the people of the book is sahur, pre-dawn meal. So this is a sunnah. He also said it is kind of an order from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, "Tasahharu, eat sahur. Fa'ina fis sahuri barakah." Because when eating sahur, there is a blessing in it. So eat sahur. Don't forget that. Don't be lazy, especially when you know after several days of fasting we kind of lazy to eat sahur. Eat sahur. This is a sunnah. This is the way we attend taqwa, inshallah. What is the second one? The second one is try to be patient and stay away from indulging with things that is not good or wasting your time indulging with the obscene language. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Asyamu junnatun." Fasting is a shield, protection. So whoever fasts, then he said, "Fala yarfus." Don't say something that is inappropriate. "Wala yashab." Don't do things that is not appropriate. "Wala yajhal." Don't doing foolish thing during fasting time. "Wa imru'un qatalahu aw syatamahu falyaqul inni sha'imun. Inni sha'imun." Marratain. Twice he said that. So when someone want to fight with you or quarreling with you, whether in the real time or in the social media, Facebook, Twitter, whatever, then say it. "Inni sha'imun. I am fasting. I will not indulge with this kind of thing. I want to attain taqwa to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." What is the next one? The next one is solat tarawih. And it is better if you solat tarawih behind imam until it finish. Because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Innahu man qama ma'al imam hatta yansarifa kutiba lahu qiyam laila." Whoever pray Whoever pray the tarawih behind imam until finish, as if he will get the reward, as if he finish the whole Lailatul prayer for the whole night. So this is the reward for praying behind the imam tarawih until finish. What is the next one? Remember, Ramadan is the month of Quran. Sahur Ramadan unzila fihi al-Quran hudan linnas wa bayyinatin minal huda wal furqan. This is the time when we have to indulge ourselves in reading Quran. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, afdalu ibadati ummati qira'atul Quran. The best ibadah that my ummah did or do is reading Quran, because no other nation reading Quran. So this is the best thing that we to do. Insyaallah is also during Ramadan increase that recitation of Quran. The next one is supplication. Ask doa to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala said, wa idza sa'alaka 'ibadi anni fa inni qarib ujibu da'wata da'i idza da'an. If my servant asking about me, tell them that I am close. I will answer the one that could call me. So that's the requirement. In order to get answer from Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, we have to call, make a dua, make a supplication. Then Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will answer that call, especially during Ramadan. Because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, salah satu la turaddu da'watuhum. There are three people that their dua will not be rejected. Who are they? The first one is as-sa'imu hatta yuftir. The fasting person until he break the fast. So during the day is the best day in Ramadan to ask Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, make dua. What is the second people that will not be rejected? Wal imamul adil, the leader, the just leader. What is the third one? Wa da'watul mazlum, the supplication of people being oppressed. So these are that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, the three kind of people that will not be rejected if they make a dua. Especially right now is the people that fasting in Ramadan. What is the next one? What's the next manner? The next adab. Breakfast as early as possible after hearing azan. Do not wait. Because this is the one that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did and his companion did. Whenever you hear azan, then break the fast. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this one sahabah said that anna Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam qala la yazalu an-nas bi khairi ma ajjalul fitr. The people will continue to prosper as long as they hasten the breaking of the fast. The next one is, this is what Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam also do, is eating, break the fast with small things like date or water. Karena Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam yuftiru ala rutabatin qabla an yusalli. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam break his fast with the fresh date before prayer. I mean before Maghrib prayer. So break the fast first. Fa in lam takun fa ala tamarat. If there is no fresh date, then he break the fast with the dry date. Fa in lam takun hasa hasa watin min ma. If there is no date, then he just break the fast with sip of water. So this is a sunnah to break the fast as soon as possible when we hear the answer. The next one is giving food to the fasting people. So alhamdulillah, in our community we have a sponsorship for iftar. This is very beneficial, and also there are a lot of reward for doing this. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, "Man fattara sha'iman kana lahu mithlu ajrihim min ghairi ayyankusa min ujurihim syai'a." Whoever give food for breaking the fast, then he will get the reward like the people that fasting, that use, you know, eat his food for breaking the fast without taking the ajar, the reward for each individual people. So you can imagine if we sponsor the food for 100 people, it means that inshallah we will get another 100 reward for fasting in Ramadan. So this is the reward for giving food for breaking the fast for people that fast in Ramadan. The next one, insyaAllah, is itikaf, if we can, in the masjid, especially at the last 10 days of, or 10 nights of Ramadan. I know in this masjid, there is a requirement, there is a limitation for itikaf, only 15 people, but if you can, do itikaf. And the itikaf has to be performed in the Jami' Masjid, masjid that is used for 5 daily prayers and also Friday prayer, because you cannot leave the masjid during itikaf. It's gonna be invalidate your itikaf. So that's the another things that we can do, or adab or manner for during Ramadan to attend that. Then the last one, insyaAllah, is if you can perform umrah in Ramadan. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Umratun fi Ramadan ta'dilu umratan aw hijjatan ma'i." Whoever perform umrah in Ramadan as if he is performing umrah or hajj with me, with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's the reward for performing umrah in Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the easiness, the ability to do this adab, this manner during the Ramadan. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our fasting, accept our praying at night. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Karim wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bima fihi min al-ayati wa dhikril hakim wa taqabbalallahu minni wa minkum tilawatahu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. Alhamdulillah alladhi khalaqas samawati wal ardi wa ikhtilafil laili wan nahari la ayatin li ulil albab. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan 'abduhu wa rasuluhu la nabiyya ba'da. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. قال الله تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات ويا قاضي الحاجات. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به. واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا. أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين وجعلنا للمتقين إماما. رب اجعلنا مقيم صلواتنا ومن ذرياتنا. ربنا وتقبل دعاء. ربنا تقبل منا صيامنا وقيامنا وركوعنا وسجودنا إنك أنت السميع العليم. وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. ربنا آتنا من لدنك رحمة وهيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. واذكروا الله العظيم ولذكر الله أكبر. أقيم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله.